1 cubed is 1. Add 2 cubed and we will get 9. The sum of the first 3 cubes equals 36. Of the first 4 cubes is 100. Try to find a pattern here. Can you come up with a formula that will work for any natural number? Interesting thing is that it not only exists, but also has a geometric interpretation. Let's have a look at a unit cube. It will be the first term. Then look at the cube with edge 2. Next to them, we will place 3 cubed. For clarity, n will be 4, but the sequence of cubes can be extended. You can see for yourself what happens next. We successfully rearranged cubes so that we have a square base now. And also, we know the length of each side. According to all of these, the sum of the cubes of the first 10 natural numbers is equal to the square of their sum. While these cubes are still here, I want to remind you that the square of any natural number can be broken down to the sum of the first n odd numbers. Seems that with the same sum of squares, everything should be easier. But now, try to find a pattern. 1, 5, 14, 30. What is the formula that describes this sequence? Think about it. Here I will show a geometric approach. The bottom layer of the pyramid consists of 9 cubes. The middle layer consists of 4. And one last cube is placed on the top. If we build more layers, this transformation will still work. How exactly they do this, you will see right now. If initially we were looking at the pyramid with the size of the base n, then the width of the parallelepiped is also equal to n. Its length is 2n plus 1, and the height equals n plus 1. Did you notice how many pyramids we use? Exactly 6. This is why the volume of one pyramid equals the sum of the squares and can be found as n times n plus 1 times 2n plus 1 over 6. This formula can be proved strictly mathematically by induction. The link you will find in the description. Now it's time for questions. One is easy and another one is hard. All of you know what we can construct with squares whose sides are 3 and 4. According to the Pythagorean theorem, we can construct from them square of side 5. Can we make something particularly useful from cubes with sides 3, 4, and 5? And does this construction work for more general cases? And here's a second riddle. Imagine you threw 3 dice. What is the most probable sum of points in this case? You will see a hint in a second. So think critically, do math, take care.